はい、
Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you for waiting.
We would like to start the announcement
of the fiscal year 2011 third quarter financial results of Nissan Motor Company Limited.
Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for taking your time out of your tight schedule.決算内容の説明の後に質疑の時間を設けておりますけれども、共にインターネット中継を行っておりますので、あらかじめご承知いただきたいと思います。それでは早速ですけれども、執行役員の田川より決算内容の説明をさせていただきます。田川さん、
the floor is yours.
皆さんこんにちは。
Yes, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am in charge of IR. My name is Tagawa. Thank you for joining us today for the announcement of Nissan's earnings for the third quarter of fiscal year 2011. Today, I'm going to talk you through some of the operational and financial highlights of the three-month and nine-month period to December 31st, 2011. After this, I would be happy to take any questions you may have. Once again, I am pleased to report that Nissan's operational, financial, and market performance has been encouraging during a period marked by continued uncertainty in the global economy. Nissan has delivered robust sales performance and remains solidly profitable despite the challenges posed by an appreciating yen and a macroeconomic environment overshadowed by Europe's sovereign debt crisis and signs of slowing economic growth. Our company has benefited from continued demand around the world for Nissan and Infiniti vehicles, with total industry volumes rising in almost every market. For the 9 months ending in December 31st of 2011, Nissan is reporting consolidated net revenues of 6,698.4 billion yen, and operating profit of 427.8 billion yen, which equates to an operating margin of 6.4%, and net income of 266.1 billion yen, which represents a 4% net margin. Free cash flow for the auto business totaled a positive 173 billion yen, and we remain in the net cash position of 357.2 billion yen.During the period, Nissan continued to benefit from the prompt resumption of production following the March 2011 Japan earthquake. The company has also successfully minimized disruption caused by the flooding in Thailand. For the October to December period, the impact on production was approximately 33,000 units in Thailand, with no effect on production in other countries. Our recovery was a testament to the hard work of employees around the world. As a result, we are confident in our ability to overcome challenges to our business with both discipline and speed. Given this progress and despite the challenging macroeconomic environment, we remain confident that Nissan will deliver solid full-year revenues and profitability, although the impact of the strong yen continues to have a negative impact on full-year fiscal 2011 results. Before going through the financial results in more detail, I will outline some of the operational highlights of the period.The third quarter has been characterized by continued operational progress and positive strategic announcements across the group. We are encouraged by the early signs that Nissan can deliver on the demanding targets of Nissan Power 88, our midterm business plan targeting a sustainable operating margin of 8% as soon as possible, and global market share of 8% by 2016. One of the important strategies of the plan is to optimize Nissan's zero-emission leadership. The Nissan Leaf has become the most popular vehicle of its type in the industry. In addition, the Nissan Leaf was awarded Car of the Year in Japan. Globally, sales volumes reached a cumulative total of 22,100 units through December.
No other global automaker is as engaged in comprehensive activities to advance the entire system of zero emissions needed to make sustainable mobility a reality.
New technologies continue to roll out, including the ENV200 concept, the home power supply system through Nissan Leaf, and Nissan's own affordable quick charger.
新たな技術を多く発表しています。この数ヶ月間でも複数の革新的な商品と次世代のモビリティを目指した取り組みをご紹介いたしました。例えばロサンゼルスオートショーで初披露した米国で生産予定の高級クロスオーバーインフィニティ JX、 広州モーターショーで公開したベニシアブランドの第1弾 D50, the first product model for the new Venusia brand.
at the Guangzhou Motor Show in China. At the Tokyo Motor Show, Nissan displayed NV350 Caravan. In Delhi, we showed the Evalia 7-seat family car at the Auto Expo. And most recently, Nissan made the first presentation of the Pathfinder concept at the North American International Auto Show. The introduction of such vehicles aims to build on the continued popularity of our brands, particularly in the fast-growing BRIC economies of Brazil, Russia, India, and China. Nissan is continuing to invest in localized production to meet demand in such markets. This was reflected in this reporting period by the completion of the second Wadu plant in China alongside our Chinese partner Dongfeng. This will become the largest production complex for Nissan globally. As a result, Nissan Dongfeng's total capacity in China will be 1.2 million units based on two shifts. Our expansion in China has been matched by continued investment in the Americas, where last year, Nissan announced plans for a new plant in Resende near Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. More recently, we have decided to increase our presence in Mexico with an all-new manufacturing complex in Aguascalientes. This facility, which will complement Nissan's two existing Mexican factories, is scheduled to begin operations in late 2013. During phase one of its development, the new complex will support production of up to 175,000 units annually. The addition of an incremental production site in Aguascalientes will pave the way for Nissan to produce more than 1 million units annually in Mexico in the midterm. In calendar year 2011, the Renault-Nissan alliance, including Aftovaz, achieved over 8 million unit sales, making us one of the largest vehicle groups in the world. The strategic cooperation with Daimler, which includes joint production and technology, continues to be an important area of focus. Last month in Detroit, Nissan and Daimler unveiled the latest phase of our cooperation with plans to manufacture Daimler's four-cylinder gasoline engines together for Mercedes-Benz and Infiniti at Nissan's powertrain plant in Decatur, Tennessee. Production will begin in 2014, with installed capacity of 250,000 units per year once full ramp-up is achieved. The joint venture between Nissan and Ashok Leyland is already a success story. Last month at the Delhi Auto Expo, we unveiled the joint venture's second vehicle, the Style, which is expected to start production next year. I will go now through our overall performance for the third quarter in detail, starting with the unit sales numbers across the regions. For the 9 months ending December 31st, overall global industry volumes increased 3.9% to 55.78 million units. Nissan's overall sales results were up 13.6% at 3,429,000 units. In each market, we once again outperformed the industry's overall volume trends and ended the period with our global market share up 0.5 percentage point at 6.1%. Looking across the regions, in Japan, total industry volume, or TIV, decreased 11.3% to 3.07 million as volumes continued to show the adverse impact of the March earthquake. Nissan contained its retail volume decline at just 2%, while our market share rose 1.3 percentage points to 14%. Strong sales of the Serena and Juke contributed to our share gains, while sales of Nissan Leaf reached almost 6,000 units. Furthermore, cumulative sales total approximately 10,000 units since its launch. In China, TIV over the period increased 4.7% to 12.6 million units. Nissan sales increased by 20.1% to 907,000 units. The Tiana, Sunny, and Qashqai were the main contributors to our sales growth. In the October to December period, our sales continued to show positive momentum, increasing 26.8%. And for the full calendar year, unit sales in China grew by 21.9% to 1.25 million units, improving our market share by 1.1 percentage points to 7.3%.
次に北米ですが、米国の全体需要は前年比 7.5% 増の972万台となりました。当社の販売は 11.3% 増の75万7000台に達しました。アルティマ、ローグ、そしてバーサが大きく貢献しています。日産リーフの販売も累計9200台に達し、各販に寄与しました。当社の米国の市場占有率は前年比 0.3 ポイント増の 7.8% となりました。一方、カナダでは販売台数を 2.1% 伸ばし、6万6400台となりました。メキシコでは市場占有率 25% と引き続き好調で、17万4100台の販売を記録いたしました。欧州の全体需要は前年比 4.1% 増の1381万台となりました。当社の販売は市場の伸びを大きく上回り、前年比 20.8% 増の51万4000台となりました。市場占有率は 0.5% と 0.5 ポイント増の 3.7% に達しました。最大の牽引役はジュークとキャシカイです。特筆すべきはロシアで、当社の販売台数は前年比 59.5% 増の11万6000台を記録し、市場占有率は 5.4% に伸びました。ASEAN、アフリカ、中南米など、その他の市場では、当社の販売台数は前年比 14.2% 増の58万1000台となりました。中南米では 33.4% 増の16万200台に達し、特にブラジルにおいては前年比 90.2% 増の5万3800台を記録しました。インドネシアでも急成長を果たし、販売台数は 54.5% 増の4万4400台となりました。またインドでは前年の倍以上に相当する1万7200台を達成いたしました。では2011年度第3四半期までの累計の財務実績をご説明いたします。連結売上高は前年比2766億円増の6兆6980億円となりました。台数増を中心とする増収が為替変動による減収を相殺しました。連結営業利益は4278億円となり、売上高営業利益率は 6.4% となりました。当期純利益は2661億円、売上高当期純利益率は 4% です。第3四半期までの実績では為替変動、原材料価格の上昇、そして販売費用の増加による減益が台数増と購買コスト削減の増益を上回りました。2010年度第3四半期に対する営業利益の増減要因を詳しくご説明いたします。1501億円の為替変動による減益は、主として米ドルに対する円高によるものです。エネルギー費と原材料価格の上昇は1061億円の減益要因となりました。購買コスト削減は1543億円の増益要因です。台数差し構成は1219億円の増益要因となりました。販売費用の増加は951億円の減益要因となりました。研究開発費は158億円増加しています。販売金融事業は433億円の増益要因となりました。サービス保証費の減少を含むその他の項目は265億円の増益要因です。以上、第3四半期までの累計では減益となりましたが、2011年10月から12月までの3ヶ月間の連結営業利益は1181億円となり、前年同期の1140億円に対して増益となりました。長期化する円高や原材料価格の上昇などの逆風にもかかわらず、増益となったことは今後への自信につながります。2011年度第3四半期末の自動車事業実質有利子負債は引き続きキャッシュポジションを維持し3572億円となりました。年度当初の為替水準に置き換えればキャッシュポジションは4460億円となります。日産はグローバルで着実に歩を進めているということを改めて申し上げたいと思います。私どもは2011年度第3四半期も確かな成果を上げ、7四半期連続で利益を計上しました。今年の業績は特定の市場地域に偏らないバランスの取れた成長に支えられています。おかげさまで日産の商品は世界中でご好評We are seeing strong acceptance for our products such as the Sunny, Altima, Juke, Qashqai, and importantly, the Nissan Leaf. The reliability and emotional appeal of such vehicles is driving sales growth in all markets. 私どもが日産パワー88の意欲的な目標達成に自信が持てるのもこれらの商品力のおかげです。グローバル経済はまだ不透明で長期化する円高はさらに深刻になりつつあります。欧州の経済不安も続いています。そのような中、当社は引き続きコストの効率化、フリーキャッシュフローの創出、そしてバランスシートの管理に力を入れていきます。当社は日産パワー88の達成に向けて着実に歩を進めています。今後どのような課題に直面しても速やかに対応できる力の維持向上に努めてまいります。ご清聴ありがとうございました。
はい、では続きまして質疑に入らせていただきたいと思います。ご質問のある方は挙手をお願いいたします。マイクをお持ちいたしますので、ご質問の前に会社名とお名前をお願いします。ご質問についてはお一人様申し訳ございませんが、2問までで答えていただければと思います。では、ご質問を受けたいと思います。はい、ご質問を受けたいと思います。ご質問を受けたいと思います。
時事通信社の渡辺と申します。2点お伺いします。まずタイの洪水についての影響ですが、これ本年にはどのぐらいのインパクトがあったでしょうか。2点目は法定為替レートなんですが、下期の80円ドル に対して110円というのは変わってないんじゃないかと思いますが、その理由はどういったことでしょうか。以上にお願いします。
はい、単位の影響は財政影響33,000台を申し上げまして、これは前回、アミケル決算表の時も、当初見積もりで、大国内で4万台、国内で2万台のリスクがあると申し上げまして、その影響申し上げたいんですが、これは実際には手元に数字もございませんし、3万台ということで3万3000台ということですから、決算の方は皆さんでも知っていただけるかと思いまして、こちらの方では特に数字を出しはしておりません。So we are not making figures available from our part. Now the currency exchange rate assumption in November last year, when we made announcement, it is true that 80 yen to the dollar, 110 yen to euro, that was the announcement we made. However, this time around, the outlook itself has not been changed this time, P&L outlook. So we don't have any numbers to give you in order to revise. However,We have been making our efforts, taking the reality into account. We are not going to change any currency exchange assumption, and we didn't review any outlook for P&L. So there is no change from the last announcement we have made. So we haven't made any assumption change.
Okay, next question, please. Yes, a person at the very front, please.
朝日新聞、My name is Miyazaki. One question is about the full year forecast and the forex impact based on operating profit.
What is the forex impact that you assume on the full year forecast? And another question is about the Eurozone financial uncertainties. In emerging countries, I assume that you are enjoying significant growth, but how does Eurozone impact the emerging markets? How do you assume it or foresee it?In your full year performance? These are my questions. Thank you. Yes, thank you for your question. The forecast, we haven't revised the forecast for the full year, so it's very difficult to disclose the assumptions. But regarding the forex impact, up to the third quarter, 150 billion yen of impact is what we suffer. Not only US and Japanese yen and other currencies are in the negative movement. Therefore, in the fourth quarter, we assumed a negative impact from forex in the fourth quarter. Previously, for example, we said thatIf there is a 1 yen fluctuation against the US dollar, we gave you the estimation of the impact on our performance. And per yen, in operating profit, there is an impact of about 20 billion yen full year. And this hasn't changed significantly since then. So depending on the forex exchange, there may be an impact on the fourth quarter.
それから欧州の金融不安、あるいはそれの全体に与える影響というのは、非常に我々としてもこれ慎重かつ、重要な影響を受けているところでございます。We are very careful and cautious. 重要 な要素になるというふうに思っていまして、
and we believe that this may be an important factor.
今回ですね、年度の見通しを変えなかった、
we haven't revised the full year forecast, and one of the reasons we're not making a revision is because we
don't,
we wanted to see how the eurozone uncertainty impact the Q4, and how there may be a possibility that the eurozone uncertainty may impact the fiscal year 2012. We are still watching.And things are still uncertain. So sales, not only sales within Europe, but as you said, the uncertainties in Europe may impact Japan, US, or emerging countries eventually.
So
as a result of assuming these risks, up till third quarter, our latest performance has been strong. But in the forecast, when we looked at the possibility of upward revision of full year forecast, we're cautious about the uncertainties. So looking at the Forex and Eurozone, we are very cautious in looking at these two factors.
はい、次のご質問です。
Next question.
一番後ろの。
The person in the back.
ロイターのキムと申します。
Reuters, Kim is my name.
購買コストのところなんですけど、1543億円という
金額を聞いたんですけど、この辺の内訳をもし、
could you give me a breakdown of that purchasing cost? Second question. Power 88,
in that program, domestic production of vehicles, the parts will be sourced, 40% of parts will be sourced from LCC. So you would like to raise LCC procurement rate to 40%. So could you give me the progress?
はい、購買コストの削減はですね、
これは今
まで過去もそうでしたし、今現在もそうなんですけれども、すべての限定活動の集大成でありますので、当然その部品の強化から、あるいはコモナイゼーションの部品を簡素化する、
and also simplification of parts and the reduction of the number of parts required, so complexity reduction. So all these efforts are culminating into these figures, about 4%.
4%を超えるような金額が毎年出てきておりまして。
The costs reduction is being achieved every year. When we made a four-year forecast in the beginning of the year, 200 billion yen of purchasing cost reduction was expected. That's what we said in the beginning. So toward that objective, 154.3 billion yen to the third quarter on a cumulative basis, we have made that progress. So the breakdown of this reduction amount can be something you can easily imagine. Now regardingDomestic production related parts procurement, as you have pointed out aptly, in the past we have communicated to some of you as of 2009 domestically, about 20% of parts have been imported parts for our domestic production. So we were saying that we'd like to increase it to 40% or more. So we have been making efforts to that end. Today, at present, I cannot give you how much ratio we have achieved.So far. However, timing at which we can achieve 40%, when we compiled a midterm business plan in 2013, we wanted to achieve 40%. Given the current circumstances, we have to accelerate our efforts to increase imported parts ratio.
Thank you very much. Next question, please.
一番前の方。
The person at the front, please.Yes, Nihon Keizai Shimbun. My name is Hoshi. Regarding the investment plan, I have a question. In Mexico and Brazil and China, you are making investments. Capital investments are made to attain the goals of Nissan Power 88, and the amount is likely to go up. Looking at the free cash flow, as investment grows, how are you going to utilize effectively the cash? What is your line of thinking around the source of funding of the investment?
Yes, thank you for your question.
As you indicated, our vehicles are very popular across the globe. But if the investment inflates and the fixed costs go up, this is a challenge. So we're always careful about it. In the midterm plan, capital investment and R&D expenses in total, we have a cap of 9% against the total revenue for the total amount of R&D expenses and the capital capital investment, according to our forecast, while forecast is in line with our policy, depending on the year, it may hover around 9 percentile or 8 percentile, but 9% against the revenue. Within this framework, we are making investments for the capacity increase.
It's
not only about the capacity, but in the technical side or even in the R&D side, if there are possibilities to partner with someone else, we will maximize these opportunities. I talk about partners. Well, it may be alliance partner, not only Renault, of course. Daimler may be one possibility, or Dongfeng, or Ashok Leyland, or even in other countries, there are different opportunities of partnership. So as much as possible, we try to make sure that we don't overly grow the investments by doing it by all by ourselves. In order to attain the free cash flow and the net automotive debt, we need to make improvements in these figures, and that's our intention. Thank you.
Next question.
マガジン X の新庄です。
I have been asking the same question to all the manufacturers. The spring labor offensive and cost reduction, as mentioned earlier, imported parts will be increased to 40%, you said, and also you would like to accelerate that effort. But Mr. Ishida already, as a representative of the industry, said that he wants to maintain manufacturing in Japan, and Nissan wants to maintain 1 million car production in Japan. So, however, JAMA is saying that, yes, it is true that products can be produced in Japan 1 million units. However, in terms of parts procurement, it may go down even if you maintain production here. And also, suppliers' situation is not so favorable. So from the perspective of cost reduction, procurement, to what extent can you make efforts in the area of procurement, but on the other hand, to what extent do you try to bring benefits to suppliers? The labor costs, since the spring labor offensive is coming up, Nishihara-san of Nissan is a top person in charge, so the profits have to be allocated between trade union and shareholders and the management. How are you going to allocate, distribute profits? Your questions are multifaceted, and also it is oriented to the management team, so I would like to respond to the extent possible. Regarding spring labor offensive, we have not received any request yet. We are going to receive requests in the middle of this month, I guess. So at this point in time, there is nothing that I can comment on. And secondly, yes, it is true that yen is appreciating. That is very challenging. We would like to maintain domestic production to a certain extent that is meaningful and significant. As you aptly mentioned, by producing 1 million units, even in that case, parts, if we are importing parts or if we are using domestically produced parts, there is a difference. I understand that. In our case, for example, together with the government officials, we have meetings and discussions. We say that if yen's appreciation continues and hollowing out of the industry continues, and that would give a negative impact on the labor situation and employment. That's what we have been saying. However, as a business, as a company, if the costs are so different between Japan and overseas, and if we are to continue to use highly expensive cost parts, that is not very good for stakeholders, including shareholders. That is not very convincing to those stakeholders. So we are going to make efforts to reduce costs, and also suppliers are making efforts as well. So we would like to stimulate each other, and we would like to work together so that we would like to increase quality and reduce costs. So we have to make a steadfast efforts together.
Thank you. Next question, please.
ウォールストリートジャーナルのドーソンと申します。まず、当期の為替要素は変わってないというふうにおっしゃったと思うんですけども、
You haven't changed the forex assumption for the fiscal term, but in the quarter four, the U.S. yen,
どのようになっているかどうか、
What is your forecast of U.S. Japanese yen forex rate?
四半期の販売費と
購買費を教えていただけないでしょうか。はい、
当期の為替、当期といいますか、第4四半期の為替の前提条件というのは、
Forex assumption for Q4 is not determined.
11月に、
In November last year, we showed you the full year forecast, and we said it's 80 yen to the US dollar. These were the assumptions that we unveiled.
その時に出した全体的な見通しを変えなかった。
So the overall assumptions remain unchanged.
For example,
this is how the Forex looks like,
or
this, in this region, we have a strong sale, so it looks like this. In the other P&L items, we haven't revised all the specific items because we didn't do any revision in a full year. So the assumed Forex of Q4 does not exist. We haven't made one. That's one. And the second question, what was the second question? Excuse me. Sales expenses.
Okay. The,
it may be a busy chart. Page 20 was it? At the bottom, you find the third quarter alone, negative and positive factors.
確かの販売
If I remember correctly, in the selling expenses and the purchasing cost, I think these were the items, and the rest of the items, you see the impact for the third quarter alone at the bottom. As you can see on the chart, for example, Forex and the raw materials and purchasing cost reduction is similar to the trends of the first half of the year, but in the volume and mix, because the sales significantly grew in the third quarter,And the mix deteriorated at the same time. So in the third,
but
this was alleviated in third quarter. So in the volume and mix, we see a positive factor in third quarter alone. Looking at the selling expenses in third quarter, or whether it's in the full year, it's on the negative side. Why? One of the main reasons is that the volume is rising, and as a result, the selling expenses are rising. Per unit selling expenses.Is falling, in fact. So the higher volume, sales volume, is one reason, and we are making investments in brand building. And we are also focusing on building brands for the long term rather than the short term. So as a result, the expenses grew in the third quarter. So that turned into a negative factor.
ついでに申し上げますと、
just for your reference, R&D expense up to the first half of the year was on the positive factor.Compared with the last year, in the full year basis, R&D expenses was assumed at 40 billion yen on the full year in terms of increase against the last year. So from the third quarter, we are catching up.
地震とか大影響がなくなった第三、まあ、少し和らいできた第三四半期に
In the third quarter, the impact of earthquake and flooding is alleviated, so we are spending more for R&D expenses in the third quarter. The rest of the items are similar to the first half of the year.
はい、ありがとうございます。では、
Thank you very much.
次の質問になります。一番前の方。
The person in the front row.
日経新聞の小谷と申します。
日経小谷
まず1点目なんですけども、まあ、引き続き販売が非常に好調ということで、
先ほど、商品力
というようなお話が出ましたけども、
product,
その商品力の背景に
はですね、Lying behind these popular products you are selling, what is your strength? So, in order to increase attractiveness of products, what kind of efforts are being made? And also, in what way your past efforts have been leading to such a good results? That's what I would like to know. And also, secondly, the full year forecast was not changed, you said. No revision to the outlook. However, in your explanation, there is a Eurozone risk which has been reflected in your.Outlook. Because of that, you didn't make any change to the outlook. At this point in time, do you have any concrete ideas in terms of expenses which is expected to increase in the fourth quarter? Is there any examples, or rather, you have a going, you are not changing the outlook?
because of the risk factor.
Let me take up the second question first. All in all,
リスク対応で、
in order to respond to risks,
特にその個別に何かですね、第4四半期で、
on a specific basis, in fourth quarter, new risks are to be incorporated into a revision. That is not the case. Rather, there are seasonal factors, as I said before, R&D expenses and other general expenses. Last year and the year before, as you could remember, in the fourth quarter of those years, there is a tendency that certain expenses will increase in the fourth quarter. They are reflected in our forecast. And also, it isn't that we assume further yen's appreciation or what kind of specific risks can be materialized on a specific basis. That exercise has not been done. Rather, we are remaining very cautious. Now, the factors contributing to the attractiveness of products, if I may say, I have a lot of things to tell you on this front. However, simply put, needless to say, we have to produce cars which we can sell to our customers. We have to capture needs of customers. We have to create cars which accommodate their needs. So the region segments, countries and technology, all these factors are important in order to capture customer needs and to produce cars which cater to their needs. I think the similar efforts are being made by any other manufacturer. For example, in a successful market, China, the growing market, another growing market, Brazil and Russia, in those growth markets, the competition will be fierce in the future. So V platform is something we are going to focus on, particularly for compact car. We are ahead of others. We have been doing a lot of proactive things compared to other manufacturers. However, competitors will come on as well. However, EV, electric vehicles, there is no great demand for EVs. However, by producing electric vehicles, our brand equity has enhanced. And we have been receiving a lot of questions and inquiries. So I think all these efforts will continue to produce a positive impact.
Thank you. Next question, please.
NHK の影と申します。
NHK, my name is Kage.
円高についてお伺いしたかったんですけども、
販売伸びてますが、若干営業利益減益になったんですけど、やっぱり円高の影響が大きいかなと思うんです。改めてちょっとインパクトについてどうお考えになっているのか、今円高の対策ですね、具体的にどういうことをしていらっしゃるのか、あとまあ中国、アメリカ各地で販売伸びてますけども、まあ中国では景気ちょっと戻ってきているんじゃないかと、またヨーロッパでは金融不安もあります。
There is an impact of the uncertainties or anxiety. What do you hear from the regional sales team by region, please? Yes, thank you for your question regarding the strong yen. The existing or current level of Japanese yen is abnormal. That's how we see it. On top of this, over the past three or four years, we experienced a sharp fluctuation or volatility of the foreign exchange. And what do we do to counter this? We localize production and we made specific announcements around this. For example, Infiniti JX. This is the vehicle which will be produced in the United States. And Next Generation Rogue, which is produced in Kyushu, will be localized too. Besides this, we have other pieces of plans.
This is
one countermeasure against strong yen on the assembly side. As you asked, besides these efforts, we work on import parts for the production in Japan. We adopt import parts for the production in Japan.
まあ、考え方として、
What is our philosophy? Whether it's within Japan or outside Japan, that's not the line of thinking. We try to produce and sell within the same market and make sure we assemble the powertrain and transmissions locally. That's our philosophy. Or we will utilize our, the partners, or we maximize opportunities of using partners. That's what we are proceeding. But as I said at the beginning,
It doesn't mean that the current level of foreign exchange.まあ、現在のですね、利益率というのも我々は決して満足できている
ではありませんので、まあ、
やはり円高については非常に懸念をしているということでございます。それから中国、欧州、
まあ、マクロの影響、
まあ、もしくはその現状どういう意見が来ているのかということなんですけれども、
What are the voices of the Gemba or region? That was your question. Looking at the latest performance in both countries, our sales have been strong.
まあ、欧州につきましても、
In Europe,
歴年で言えば2011年度 25%
we grew by 25%.
1月の販売も
sales in January,
数字が出てましたけれども、1月も 15% の増加ということで、
we grew by 15%.
私どもの販売はですね、これはロシアだけでなく西ヨーロッパにつきましても、
not only in Russia but in West Europe, we are enjoying strong sales. So we don't see any immediate concerns in Europe at this moment.
それから中国もですね、
and how about in China?
2011年の前十は、
the TIV in 2011 grew by only one digit.
私ども先ほどお示ししましたように、まあ、約 22% の、増加ということで、こちらも私どもの販売まあ、あるいは需要につきましては、
our sales or the demand for our products have been strong.
ご案内のように1月は中国は、
in January, in China, there was a new year. It took place in February last year, but it took place in January this year. And Dongfeng Nissan's dealers' working days were 8 days shorter than last year. So negative 28% was the reference point in China.
And looking at
the sales in China declined by 16% in January. So compared with this 28% of decline, we declined by only 60%. So our momentum has been strong with a double-digit growth. The selling models like Sunny, which is popular, or Tita Sedan, which is another popular vehicle, in January, we sold by 14,000 units and 13,000 several hundred respectively.So far, sales have been strong. But as I said, we foresee risks carefully. That's our perception. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。そろそろ時間が参りましたので、最後の質問にしたいと思いますが、どなたかいらっしゃいますか。よろしいですか。
Anybody? No?
はい、ないようですので、これをもちまして2011年度第三四半期決算の説明会を終わらせていただきます。どうもありがとうございました。
Third quarter financial results. Thank you very much.
ありがとうございました。